Bob Coppedge. And Bob, I'm taking a page out of your book. I'm out doing a walkabout, a walk and talk, because your videos, you've been doing a little bit of that lately. Talk to me about that. Then I want to talk to you about the evolution of IT. But what, with your daily snippet, you're getting outside. What's going on?
Well, my wife just got tired of me doing, but no, seriously. The bottom line is you always want to have, whenever you're doing posts, you want to have some differences. So, and honestly, I finally figured out how to get rid of the autofocus nuances on my phone. And so now I'm on the road, man, not quite the nice place you're at.
Well, there we go. Yeah, I'm in Central Texas, folks. It's 79 degrees, late November, and living the dream. So with that said, Bob, we're talking about the evolution of IT. You recently dropped a video on the evolution of IT. Walk us through that thinking.
Well, and again, it starts with the fact that I'm old. And so I've been in IT since around 80 or so. Yeah. And the point I've been making, and I've actually made this during a lot of talks, number of talks and a lot, is that information technology originally was all about the technology and all about the industry working to automate things that people were doing before. As you know, the term computer used to refer to a human being who was really good at computing things. And so the first applications were payroll, were accounts payable, receivable, inventory, all that, things that we used to do by hand. And so it was the drive of technology, Moore's law, all that kind of fun stuff. But it was the tech that really drove the progress. The information really wasn't any different than we were already doing. And that to me happened or kept going till around the 90s or so, mid late 90s. And then we started actually, let's do some interesting thing with the information. Let's actually do things, decisions, forecasting, modeling, reporting on demand, all that. Let's start doing things that we couldn't do before because the tech wasn't mature enough. And so the first phase I refer to is information technology. So small I, capital T. The second phase in the 90s, when we started using both, it really became a combination of the two, capital I, capital T, so full IT. And that went on until I think earlier, about 10 years ago or so. Now, I think that a majority, and this is, there gets some definitions here, but really it's the information that's driving it. When you look at all of the nuances, all the social media, all of the advertising, the big data, the AI, the Internet of Things, all of that are because of all of these things we're doing with the information. The fact that now if you upload a picture in your camera, the metadata is actually going to automatically give a narration or a caption about what that picture contains. It's now data that's usable by all this stuff. And so now it's information is the big driver and technology is really the, is following that lead. And I think that's, we don't talk about that enough.
A couple of thoughts. Back when humans were computers. So I taught, we'll call it back in the day, I did a stint as an adjunct instructor at night. And what's an adjunct instructor do? I was teaching computers at a local college, right? And Tuesday, Thursday night. So you run out and get videos and guest speakers, right? It's a formula to be an adjunct instructor. And one of them was off of PBS. I recorded it, the History of Computers. And to your point, this particular documentary on PBS claimed the computer was invented by a British grocery store chain. And they only intended it for their use for supply chain management, inventory control, and so on. So now who knows? Everybody claimed to invent the internet, so who knows? But it was good storytelling. And that's sort of my second point. Some early works I did with the small business server product, because small business server was all in one, right? Just add water, single box, experience, et cetera. And Bob, to your point, I have a chapter in those early SBS books about why the heck are we here? And in that era, I had this diagram that showed stuff going from SQL and Exchange and this and that out to IIS and other views, because it was all about the reporting, right? We're here, it's not the zeros and ones way back before SQL Server. It's not even SQL Server. It was the output from all that, the reporting for management to make decisions. And then finally, in the modern era, I've done some work in the last 5 years where I talk about it. Really, it's storytelling with dashboards, right? So why are we here? And I'm of the camp that we're here with these little animated characters stacked on top of each other and little ski slope financial charts and a dashboard and Tableau or Power BI. That's where I currently think we've landed with information technology. I welcome your feedback, but that's my evolution.
Well, absolutely. So when you think about it from a standpoint of information as presentation, okay?
Yeah.
Which is what we used to call reports because that's all they did was they just reported. Now, whenever I talk to people about that whole concept, whether it be a dashboard or whatever, a report, and again, I hate the term because it really should be coming up with something more modern or more appropriate, does one of two things. And one is it tells a story. And tells a story as in it actually, you can look at it and you can implicitly understand a beginning and end, lessons learned, all of that. And the second is it answers a question or questions. Now, sometimes it actually creates additional questions, which is fun.
Sure does.
But the thing is that when we create those interfaces, when we create those tools, we need to know what the story is. And we need to know what are those questions we're asking, because and this is true with some of the iterations of SPS and a lot of the software that was built for it and running on it, is all we did was we just threw these 30 or 40 or 50 reports out there because we could. We could do this columnar report, all the green bar papers and all of that kind of fun stuff, but they didn't actually advance the organization forward in terms of whatever goods and process they have. And now we're almost seeing the next version of that. We have all of these great reports, but they don't necessarily answer the question or don't necessarily tell the story.
Yeah. What I like, and by the way, the big visualization ISVs, including Power BI, Tableau and the others, they have libraries of dashboards you can go snag, right? And so some really good ones, with all due respect, but some really good dashboards that are dynamic have been on the COVID analytics, right? The daily information and all that. You name it, a dashboard exists for it. But Bob, what I really like is a lot of these dashboards are dynamic. And so you can kind of move the thermometer, take it from 90 degrees down to 70 and watch the reaction in the dashboard, right? You know what? We used to call it what if. That's called what if analysis in spreadsheets, right, man.
Absolutely. And which is great, because then you get to decide what your story is going to be.
Yeah.
Because prior to it, it was the authors had to decide. The author of the report had to decide this is what the story is going to be. And now it's almost like a Build-A-Bear type of thing, in the sense that you can decide which of those, which variables are going to have greater impact or are going to be more significant in terms of the impact going. And when you take a look at, and actually this is especially ridiculously true today, because almost all reports in their inert and the original form are just based on extrapolations of what happened historically and correct, what our assumptions are in terms of what's going to happen or what's going to impact that. Well, COVID has completely thrown that out because we don't have any data as far as what pandemics or lockdowns or any of this sort of stuff has. So we have to be able to accept the fact that the initial extrapolation is at best a rough guess. And can we move things around, like you're talking about, the thermometers or whatever, to see what the impact would be? And that's true whether you're talking about what type of marketing we're going to do for Q1, Q2, versus the at what point are we going to see our orders come in or our restaurant seats be filled, or to your point, the grocery stores see this type of business or that type of business.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I'll tell you what, I think we've covered this one from A to Z. Thank you, my friend. Happy holidays. We'll realistically see you in 2021 at this point, and appreciate you being along for the ride each month.
Thank you, and have great fun there. Go feed the ducks.
Yeah, there we go. You can see those.